Welcome to ATB TV. I'm Darren Dance here with Peter Morganti on this fine Thursday afternoon. Races today at Kilmore, Pete.
Just watched the race, Darren.
Just have one go around, so we'll get to that later on. But let's wind back to last week's runners, and where do we go back to?
Go back to last Friday night. La Pietra was in the night before, but was scratched to run at Cranbourne. Ran third, she ran really well.
Nice run. I think she was second up at Cranbourne.
Yep.
And as you say, she ran third there Friday night, and it was a good progressive run. I'm sure that if she's not winning next start, Pete, she'll be winning the start after, and she does look like she's in for a good prep.
Progressing in the right way and was as strong as any horse through the line.
No, very happy with her.
Yep. On the Saturday, we had the Big Owners and Breeders Day, the Vobis, Super Vobis Day. We had three runners.
What was missing, Pete?
Us being there.
The owners. Mm.
Yeah, so it was Breeders. It was a no day. It was a lot of money day.
Big money day. Mm. But anyway, we had three starters there.
Horses run well. We didn't get the results we'd hoped for. But
no winners.
We wouldn't be disappointed with the way they ran.
No, let's go through them.
First up was Write Your Name, who ran fourth, beaten about two lengths.
Yeah, I thought he was very honest.
Yeah.
I thought he was very honest. He was well ridden. I like him ridden that way better when he's not leading and being challenged, when he's actually the one sitting off the speed and doing the challenging.
He's a bit like the stalker.
I like him like that. I think it gives him a better chance. He just got beaten by better horses on the day. Jumbo Zaki's a quality horse, probably not far off a black type horse.
Quality ride too.
And you know, I thought he ran to the best of his ability, and I was quite happy with Write Your Name.
Yep.
And I'm sure that you know, he gets the right circumstances. You know, he'll be back in the winner's circle if he's ridden that way.
So you see Williams pull out some of that, a ride like that on some of ours. Everyone rolled off the fence, and he went up the fence, and was probably too good for him.
Yeah. I spoke to Craig yesterday, actually. He rang me just to see how we're going, which was good of him.
Yep.
And he was just saying that Caulfield track, it raced beautiful, was fair and even, and... yeah, he said his horse is really flying, Jumbo Zaki. So it was no disgrace to run two lengths of that horse.
No, not at all.
So, no, he's soldiering on, Pete.
Two races later, we had Serious Suspect, and I suppose we knew it was probably one time where he wasn't going to dictate, because we had the flying mare Pippi in it, who actually beat home in the end. She went probably poorly on her record. He probably just tended to over race a little bit mid-race, but still finished off nicely. For a horse that was off of freshen up.
Yeah, he ran fifth, 1,200 at Caulfield. All his wins have been at, pretty much all these good wins have been at.
Yeah, he had one at Caulfield.
He won an easy one there first up. But look, we knew from barrier one, we were going to be, if Pippi was going to lead, it was going to lead, and therefore we'd be behind it on the fence. I mean, that's where we knew we were going to be. And we also knew that if Pippi failed, and dropped back in our lap, we were going to be in trouble. And that's exactly what happened. Pippi got the stitch probably 150, 200 out.
Yeah.
And you could see Brad straight away say,
off the fence.
Uh-oh, stuck behind it, coming back in my lap. I've got to change direction.
Yeah.
There was no room to go up the inside. So he had to try and force a passage. I don't think that's Serious Suspect's trait to be doing that sort of stuff. I think his trait is sit up, punching along outside the leader and just running that fast last 400 where they can't catch him. Whereas in this race, the middle sections, they were running sub-11s, Pete. So they ran two sectionals in the middle of the race around 10.9, 10.8. Just went too hard in those middle stages, which is probably why Pippi stopped. But unfortunately, when that happened, it affected us.
Yeah.
And we weren't able to finish off as strong as we would have liked. But the run was good. And I look forward to him getting back to Flemington.
And made the run of Ashlaw real good, because he sat outside the lead and we nearly caught him on the line.
But, yeah.
The winner and the second and third horses come from off the post, which showed the speed was on.
It's always disappointing not to win, but I think when your horse runs well and you can see why it got beat, you realise. And, you know, you chase these big money races.
Yeah.
Geez, they're hard to win. And if you look through the results, we weren't... You know, I think there was two or three pretty much odds on horses got beat on Saturday.
Yeah.
Mr. Quickie got beat. Right, Pippi got beat. I think Twitchy Frank was nearly pretty close to even money.
Yeah.
It ran no good. But, you know, it's a very, very interesting concept. A lot of money on offer and a lot of horses running well without winning. very competitive, big field, so not a lot of room. And I think we're a bit of a victim. But I don't think, you know, Serious Suspect running fifth there, first up off a break. I think he'll be super at his next start, and he gets his chance to get back into the winner's circle.
I think it highlights, and it's important, how form from one track to another can be so different.
Yeah.
You can dictate down the straight. At Caulfield, you can, if you're not drawn, well, you get dictated too. And it's just total different scenario in a race. You
know? I would have been happy to draw six or seven there.
Yeah,
Saturday,
I think so.
And just not be on the fence and just be that one that's sort of one or two off the fence.
You
and
could be the one inside the winner, and also you probably go with the winner. Yeah,
you just peel, but not to be. But
anyway, he ran up to form.
We were happy with him.
He's only beaten 1.6.
Yeah, I know, it's amazing. Yeah. 1.6 length, toss you about, what, 150 grand?
Yeah, well, just we'll get
lucky we can't go anywhere and spend it.
I was just thinking that with Hasseltoff, actually. Now, young horse should have won two, probably should have won one, maybe two by the time he got to the races on Saturday. And we knew the barrier was always going to be a little tricky. We needed to find a bump, but he got exposed. Three wide without cover, no foul of Noel Callows, just the way it unchoked. And yeah, he ran 11th, he ran 10th, we would have got 9 grand, but we got nailed right on the bloody
post. Didn't he ride him out?
Oh, I think Noel Callow rode him out.
He better have rode him out. I'm going to have a look at that.
I'd had a second look and it was like, ugh.
Did he cost us 9 grand?
No, I would like to say, in case he's watching.
I hope he is.
Nine grand's like a win in the bush.
I know. Look, the horse was on a quick backup. He'd had an arduous 2 weeks.
Yeah.
He's gone to the paddock. He was flat. Yeah. He didn't show the same zip. I know he was three wide, no cover, but he didn't really show the zip. He was tired. He was gone at the 400. He whacked away. He's a good horse. The right decision's been made to tip him out. He's home here now. He'll have a good 6 week spell, and we're going to have some fun with him in the latter part of 2020.
I just seen
when him. Maybe we can go and watch him.
I just seen him in the paddock not half an hour ago. He's lovely.
Did you get a video or a photo?
Video.
Well, maybe you can throw that on, Pete.
Well, I'll get put it on here. But
have a look at this horse. He's a standout.
Would have seen it.
He's a standout.
Lovely horse in the making.
So 6 weeks off and reload.
So that was sort of our day. We got a little bit of the prize money, but not the major end.
We're in the cheap seat, standing room only.
The day, I'm sure that's the following day on Sunday. We had Factor Fable go around at Pakenham at the back end of a jumps meeting.
On the synthetic peak.
Just, what? I can understand that apparently they couldn't move the jumps, so they just went to the synthetic for those.
Why can't they move the jumps, Pete? Back in the day, do you remember they used to run out with the tractor and get the jumps?
Should have jumped the last, they would have been moving it.
Well, I reckon they were moving them after, when they were on the second lap.
Slack, but
different world we live in.
Yeah, she ran around on the synth.
It's not like there's, we can't get people to work.
Well, maybe they weren't allowed to, they needed to be a
meter and a half apart.
Yeah, they couldn't get rid of them because they had to be too close together. I don't know. Anyway.
So they put the flat races on the synthetic.
Three benchmark. 58.
Just to fill the day up.
Just otherwise there's only going to be 5 races.
Well, we can't just let it slide that you might have had a jumps winner there that you've left us all out of last week.
Left myself out.
Oh, cut it out. I've already had a call from the Holden dealer in Ballarat checking your references. In with 20,000 cash. Hey? And you want to get number place called Felix?
I must have robbed.
What's going on?
I must have robbed a bank if I walked in.
If I go back and watch last week's edition, I don't reckon I heard one word.
Because I didn't know he was running.
Yeah.
Honestly.
You expect us to believe this?
No.
Really?
Well, when did we do that on the Thursday? the thoughts were going to Werribee tomorrow to run on the flat before Warrnambool at the carnival.
Yeah, I'm not buying. And then I'm not buying any of it.
And then Avery said, oh, we might as well try and run.
It was heavily backed.
Only because of the light scratch and the blaze.
It was heavily backed.
Blaze was scratched.
A lot of money was transferred to Ballarat bank accounts.
Not mine.
Yes, you're right. Well,
the only money that got transferred was some prize money last night into my account.
Who's the trainer?
Amy McDonald. Her husband rode it.
Where do they train at?
Out of Weary's old.
Oh, they still look across the road.
Yeah. No,
good on them. Well, yes, thanks for leaving us out, but that's okay. That'll be well remembered going forward.
When the betting went up, and I'll actually...
So you actually saw the betting go up, did you?
I'll post Amy's last report. We're going there. We cannot get within cooey of a Blaze and ZM.
Now, don't put that up there. You'll destroy her. No one will send her a horse.
And
She didn't tell you it was in, and she told you it was no hope.
No, I just wasn't sure whether it was going to run there or wherever. That was... So, we're all...
Well, pretty much you said you didn't know it was in. She told you couldn't get within cooey of the winner.
I knew it could have been in, but at that stage the fields weren't declared.
You know what I call that?
What?
Bum steer.
No.
She
didn't back it either. I said it yesterday. The Briley has been the aim, and we've just worked out this horse goes, he's in reverse to a normal jumps horse and gets better as the prime.
No, he gets worse.
He just runs super fresh.
What about running again?
Well, we're just going to wait to Warrnambool.
Wait till next year.
No, he was
Felix Bay.
Kevin Moses owns the horse.
Kevin Moses. The jump.
Yeah, and
so what did he lease him?
He was leased it out to some up in Queensland. Amy sent it because she likes the breed Songatara. They're really good jumpers and had them in the past. She annoyed Kevin for 6 months, and in the end, he relented and said, "Righto, you can train it. I'll stay in it, but you need to get rid of the other 80%." And I actually photographed their wedding. And the remuneration was about $700. And I said, "Look, don't worry about Canada's a present." And then she said, "Oh, I've got shares in horses." And I thought about it, rang back a week later. I said, "Oh, what about that Felix Bay?" She goes, "Well, you can have 5% of that." And that's how it all started.
Good on you.
12 jump starts, 4 wins, a second, 4 thirds. And the only time he was not top 4 was in the Grand National last year, where he never ran out of the 4,800. So.
Now, is it true that you're going to use the prize money to good effect? You're going on a holiday?
Beck's already got it.
You're going on a holiday, are you? You booked 2 seats on the Ruby Princess? Because they're only about $30 each.
2 kids can go on it.
Homeschool on the boat.
That was a bit of fun.
Good on you.
Yeah,
well deserved.
Something in the bank.
All right, so fact or favourite.
Yeah, so she ran after that.
Yes, no good.
No.
She had nothing.
No zest at all.
So guess what?
Online sale.
If you want to buy her, you can buy her Monday when bidding opens on the English digital online platform, because we are done.
Yeah, no. And I always hurt when I look back at the time she won at Bendigo, and a horse called Flit.
She was very, very, showed a lot of promise early, but just hasn't lived up to it. So she's got to go.
Sometimes horses just switch off, don't they? For whatever reason. Is it more so fillies than...
I agree with you. It's the way they're trained.
Oh, Jesus. Hey, Rob. We've got to go to Passaggio now.
Oh, yes. Well, we're on a roll here.
Yeah.
Now, would that be the worst debut you've ever seen in an ATB horse in your whole tenure with ATB?
That was his second run, because his debut wasn't
his first up. Would that be the worst run you've ever seen an ATB horse in the last, since you've worked this? Has there been a worse one?
Motley Prince the other day was sort of
was pretty
and similar.
Mm.
Noel Callow summed it all up in the post race, I think. He sort of couldn't quite say what he wanted to say, but he said enough.
G, ends with T, and it's a four letter word. Is that what he said?
Is that what he wanted to say? He didn't want to say. I think he might have mentioned slow, but I don't. Very diplomatic he was.
Well, give the trainer credit. He said to the owners, if it shows nothing next week, I'll give you a free replacement.
Yeah.
So I said, I'll take a share in Glenfiddich, which ran second in the big group one last Saturday.
Not too sure whether that's going to get off.
And I think I got, breaking up. Hello.
Sorry.
But anyway, Passaggio, he's going to school him, give him another run. If he shows nothing, see you later.
Bye-bye.
Can't be keeping these horses that are no good.
Well done,
Robbie Griffiths bought it. He trained the mother.
Yeah.
He should have known better.
And well done to Rob Glenfiddich. He nearly won that.
He nearly pulled off the big group one.
Yeah.
The difference between winning and running second was about $14 million stay-in deal. About 14 million.
It's unbelievable, isn't it?
We run... Oh, no, I won't give it up yet. We'll keep going.
Yesterday, Wednesday, Bendigo, Rotorua. Gate, they should have scratched. They wanted to scratch. Then they decided not to scratch.
Well, fourth emergency got a run.
Yeah, and then he was like, we better run. And to the horse's credit, he's probably... Sectionals were good late, but he had to come from
How much
further.
Ground do you reckon he covered? How far was that race?
1300.
Yeah, well, he's ran 1450.
Well, they went from sort of back last on the rail and then went... He must have lost 5 lengths somewhere. Well, I reckon he would have ran over nearly the quickest last 400 without knowing.
He got beat a long way, but Peter Gallivan's got a locksmith shop in Bendigo.
Yeah.
And he said he was standing at the counter and he saw him run straight past. That's how wide he was. He was running down the main street of Bendigo.
Was it a gradual go out wide either? It was like a diversion. I thought, oh, you'll hunt up in behind him here, but something steered him off the track, except said,
yeah, the jockey.
We'll keep that one there.
Did you see the post race?
Yeah.
He looks like he's 3 years old.
I know, he's a 12-year old, isn't he?
Have a look. If you ever get to have a look at his face, he's got a baby face.
Sounds like that.
Who's dad?
Nash.
Is that Nash's son?
Yeah. Brad's son.
I wonder
Brad's
if Nash son. Watched the replay and had anything to say.
Don't know.
What do you reckon? Like, as a dad, would you... You'd watch your son, right? Oh, you'd give him a bit of feedback, wouldn't you?
I reckon he would, yeah, for sure. Yeah. I don't know what he would have said.
Why don't we ring Nash up live on ATV and ask him?
We might have to get
Have we got his number? I've got Brad's. We got Brad's number. We can ring him.
So
what do you think of your nephew's ride on Rotorua?
And here you are. Now, here's your nephew now. You can tell him live.
And they sent me a text apologising, put the wrong colours on, copped a fine.
What happened there? Just
bought the stable colours.
So is that Warren's colours? Warren's.
Eden's.
Eden's colours. Yeah.
So apparently they mucked up the colours, got a fine. Had a good day, really.
Had a dirty day.
Anyway, I thought all things went pear-shaped. The horse showed that his run was okay. His sectionals were good.
Yeah.
And I think...
He'll be right, though.
We'll see that next time.
He'll be right. And
we'll get 50s.
And they were in
all up Felix Bay.
They were in between another trial and racing, so it will bring him on. Yeah.
All up Felix Bay.
All up Felix Bay. It's hard work watching jumpers.
Nah.
Hard work. Especially when he was last all the way, and then he... I'm thinking, what are you doing? It's 400 to go, and you haven't let him go. And then when he let him go, 1/8.
Jeez.
So I actually rang. I said, well, how'd that feel?
Did you get 400 in the running?
400 to 1? Oh, no. I was just waiting for the favourite of Paddy Payne just to go whoosh and we'll run second. And we went whoosh and it ran last.
Mm. Funny game.
Funny game. And there was money for him. It wasn't ours, so I don't know. I reckon they play funny buggers.
I reckon you know exactly what's going on. Don't. I reckon you know more than you'll
I would have drove out in that new car if I had it.
You wouldn't be game.
As you said, we watched a race just before we come on.
We did, at Kilmore.
And it was... A good result without winning for Whitemore. Third up, out to a distance that suits him a bit better at 1450, and beat 3/4.
Yeah.
Dead out for third.
And I reckon that second horse laid all over him.
The second horse of Paddy Payne.
So yeah, laid over him.
I reckon Preble, when he got the whip out, he's strong, as you said. I reckon the nose of that horse felt one. And I'm not sure whether it was Billy Egan.
Yeah.
And he said, well, that's not going to happen again. I'll get it all over the top here. And it actually just crowded him up, didn't it?
It was a good run. It was a good run.
Oh, he'd be winning.
He'd be winning. He's a good little consistent horse, that horse. We just looked it up. He's won 98,000.
It's surprising,
wasn't it? He's only won two races, but he's been around the money. I think he had 4 or 5 seconds there in a row.
And they were all sort of 6 or 7 for prize money. So.
But today he showed he's back in the groove.
Yeah.
And last prep, when he was in the groove, he just kept racing like that, didn't he?
You could see him having a crack. The ears were laid back.
Yeah.
And he went with that horse. He didn't. Sometimes horses go past you, they drop off.
Yeah, he never spat the bit out. He fought. So good on him. I thought it was a good run.
Yep.
And a good ride.
You'd love to be able to have Preble on him next start over a similar distance.
Now, we didn't talk about Motley Prince, didn't he, run this week?
No, he was...
Did we talk about it last week?
Yeah.
Still burning in my mind.
Yeah, there's been a couple of reports.
The vets didn't show anything, did it?
Vets, nothing. And
I think the report said horse ran poorly due to lack of ability or interest.
Yeah, I didn't say that at all.
Didn't it?
No.
It said it was clean.
A
bit of mucus.
A bit of mucus, but not nothing.
Nothing to stop
suggest
it.
That car.
Well, I feel sorry for the owners of that horse, Pete. It'll want to lift.
Yeah, I don't know. They were going to give him a bit of space, a bit of time, but then...
That was one that was bred by the Giroux, wasn't it?
It's trial form doesn't match.
Do they guarantee? Do they guarantee money back to the Roe family?
I'll leave that one with you.
You email Neville.
No, Neville. What do you reckon?
After your Queen of Hell effort.
My Queen of Hell. Oh yeah. Anyway.
Anyway. Oh, yeah, anyway, what's he going to do? He's going to give him a trial, isn't he?
Yeah,
put blinkers on
well,
him.
He was...
He might need blinkers, that was.
That was a... Do I give him another run without blinkers or I put blinkers on? They're going to weigh that up. They get paid the big dollars. But his trial form's been a hell of a lot better than
last year. Anyway, let's just hope it was one of those things.
Coming up.
Righto.
Tomorrow. Where
Friday,
are we?
Friday. Where is it?
Spendthrift Park.
Just down the road and I can't go.
No.
Well, I could go.
Watch over the fence.
I could watch it over the fence.
Actually, you get a bit of a view there, don't you?
If I was in the horse truck, they couldn't do nothing.
No. I'll let everyone take little parties with your horses now.
Aren't you? No. Really?
That's what I said. I didn't think animals got
the No, they don't. Well, horses don't. Dogs do, but horses don't.
Well, what are they saying? That why can't you take it? Does that mean you need another person to look after that horse? It doesn't need to be there?
I wouldn't have thought. Strange rule.
I suppose there's no two-year-old races much now. Maybe they're thinking the old horses don't need them. Geez, a lot of horses do get accompanied by ponies.
Maybe they do leave them on the float.
Well, some of them don't. Well, someone asked the question, can you even leave them on the float? It wasn't answered.
Strange world we live in, Pete.
Just some things
contradict others. But I could park, I could go to Werribee and park out the back and sit in the horse truck and watch that race.
Periscope, looking over the top.
I'd have to be in the horse truck because the police would pull me over and ask me what I was doing.
Anyway, serious deals, what we're talking about. Who are we talking about?
Yes, McCamani.
Benchmark 58, 2000. Draw the car park, 14. Fred Kersley rides. And well done to Matt and Fred, took out the big two-year-old race last week.
Yeah, they did.
That was really, what was that collect? Three quarters of a million?
A lot of money.
For a horse to come off at a Chuka maiden win.
Unbelievable. Right place, right time.
Something
like that.
It was a big win, but anyway, that's the combination we've got tomorrow. Kamani and Kersley in a 58.
Are we a chance?
They're going to roll. Matt's wanting to roll forward with the horse, and he said, even though we've drawn 14, we're still going to roll forward. There was no odds up before, but it's the only way to ride this horse.
Oh, the odds are not up?
No, they weren't before.
Right, you keep talking, I'll have a look.
Rolling forward when Dean Holland rode at Ballarat he was convincing winning that way. Now I would say now with the fitness base he's got, what's he had, four runs this time in?
What race is he in, Pete?
About race five or six, isn't it?
Has he won a race? Yeah. The odds are up, here we go.
Number
1,000
four.
Metres?
No. Next
14?
One.
No. Next. 2,000?
Yep.
No
six
fixed
one.
Odds.
Yeah.
There's no fixed odds on that race, but there's fixed odds on the others.
Probably says that they can't work out who should be favourite. Look, he's right up to it. On form, up to it in his ears. If we can get an uninhibited roll across the field to the lead or somewhere near the lead, he's going to take a hell of a lot of running down at Werribee.
See that? Best overall. Serious deal.
Hard to beat, Darren.
Hard to beat.
With luck.
Barry 11.
I don't think the kid climbs anymore, does he, in the bush?
Who is it?
Fred Kersley.
No, I don't know. Where did he come from, Perth?
Yeah. It's the grandson of Northerly driver.
Right.
So, he's dead set winning chance with luck.
All right. There. You heard it from Mr. Felix Bay.
Probably the best of ours.
Best of ours coming up. Serious deal.
Saturday, no runners, Flemington or Maui.
Good.
Sunday, Captain Harry, he's drawn 14 at Geelong.
He's only getting ready, isn't he?
And I'd say Mitchell running because he needs fitness on his side.
He needs fitness and winter's coming.
Hopefully that track will be a bit of give at it.
What's he doing there? Is he aiming him towards Warrnambool?
I think there was suggestion there's a race that suit him, but he's going to be Sandown wet mile. That's his go.
Okay.
In June.
Right.
So we're just going to get him to that level. Monday, no runners at Wodonga.
Good.
Tuesday, nominations of... At Sale, off Lord Lennox.
Lord Lennox, yeah.
Angel Lass.
Okay, let's go through these.
Lord Lennox,
Third up, he should be ready to show something.
Especially if we get him up over that trip.
Yep.
Angel Lass.
Bet of the week.
Just put BB here.
Just wins.
There you go.
And then it gets sold.
That's sort of a bit of the plan.
Yep.
And Chippewa Square... I don't know if he's
going to run there, is he?
He's looking for a race
So he won his first start by 6 or 8. But he
goes there and just nearly wins.
Yeah, so he'll be nominated for in a few places.
Yes.
I thought they said 2 to 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Maybe it's not far off.
I think they were just going to nom as they went. So
he'll be unlikely, but he'll be one to follow.
Yep. Sandown, here to Fox. Fillies and mares 1300. God, I wish they'd run 14 or 1500 metre races there, because that's what she's screaming out for.
She is.
Although the biggest thing with her is we want a dryish track.
We need dry track and we need to be winning in town, Pete.
Yeah, and Mitch, as a backup, preference Sandown has got her in the following day over 1400 at Pakenham.
Doesn't help me.
No, and Mitch is not going to run there unless... And I mean, if it's going to be wet at Sandown, it's probably going to be wet the next day anyway, so more than likely...
I think it's rain forecast. Yeah. But anyway, they might just not water the track.
So we're sort of just running out of good weather for her,
unfortunately,
because she's actually racing really well.
All right. And that's the runners we know about.
Yeah, and there'll be another batch the following week. Your Street Babies, Crackerjack Ladies, that type. Interesting commentary, Crackerjack Ladies. Still can get her fitter.
Not fit enough yet.
Yeah.
Street Baby, enormous last time.
Yeah.
Be looking forward to watching those two go around.
Yep. I haven't got my... No, I didn't bring my list. I don't know if I missed any, but we'll have a few others popping up. We've got a few that are in the breaking and pre-training and some in and out of the paddocks. A couple more to go into work next week. Deep Diversion and Urgent back in work.
Yeah, no, there's a few to go back in. And a few to come home from Paul Prushkas.
Yeah, Paul's pretty happy with the Dandino and he's happy with the Eagle and... Pins, Eagles and Pins or whatever it is, and the other two
Raise the Flag, he likes her too.
Yeah, and Husniaki is only just in the infancy of her work, but his commentary was such a much more mature, rounded horse now. So all that, I think it's a great example of all that hard work you put into their early preps. The penny either drops with it, or it doesn't, and it has with her from what we're seeing, so, or hearing.
All right.
Penthouse Playboy going good.
Encouraging.
Yeah, Stone Sand, and we'll have a couple others maybe go down there that have had a few little issues along the way.
And one of our imports, South Pacific, nice piece of work during the week at Sandown, got the Mastable up and about.
Bit excited, Kieran?
Very excited. So.
Talk about excited. He's lost his razor. What's going on there? Hey?
Well, you know.
He's starting to lose it up here. He's covered...
He's got this massive beard going on.
Remember Cat Weasel? Remember Cat Weasel?
I don't know. But he wouldn't want to go into a toilet. Someone would put him in the bowl.
Yeah. Yeah, I did some of the look. Very. Like, if he was lying on the footpath down there in Melbourne somewhere, you'd throw two bob at him.
Well, it'd be like that bloke that got lost out in the forest for about 5 years.
Yeah.
What was his name? Forest Gump.
Gumpy. Forest Gump.
Yeah.
Anyway.
All right, well, that's a wrap for this week. Oh, yes. Come on, let's go. What happened?
Lauren Plews is 2 weeks in a row. She's got her best bet up. Oh, I had a fumbled old exercise. I'll tell you, you're going cross-eyed.
Yeah. You need an auditor.
I know what I'm doing.
You need
now.
An auditor.
I'm going to have, because I got them all on one sheet.
There's a few people there that didn't tip. What happened
there? Yeah, about 30. Yeah.
Dropped off.
I should have made a rule. If you don't tip 2 weeks in a row, you're Gornsky.
Yeah.
Because then that's another name I don't have to look at. Anyway, they might come back into it.
But so who's leading?
Maureen Plews, that's Fiona's mum. Has two weeks in a row tipped her best bet. So
is she putting them in on Monday?
No, no, she got them in on time.
Jeez.
So I think collectively she's 24, and there's a group on 16 already.
Well, she's mile in front.
Yeah, she's got a good lead. She's a best bet in front sort of thing.
I reckon she's gone too hard too early, Maureen. I reckon you're going to struggle.
There's a big group behind. There's a few first starters come in last week. Thinking, we'll catch up.
Okay, good.
And they didn't score, so they're a long way behind.
Oh, well.
No, create
fun. We don't know how long this will go for. This could go to Christmas.
Well, that's right. I hope not. I've got it all on the one sheet. So this week when I've corrected it, each race is going to be on a separate bloody sheet, so I don't get the rocket. You look at... You've got 6, 9, and 2, and you're going down, and there's just a whole panel of numbers. Anyway, we got there. After I sent the last sheet out, there was
no further correspondence. Well, we'll be ended.
I earned 1 point. I earned 2 points.
There'll be no more.
No more correspondence. But anyway, it's creating a bit of entertainment.
And we must send out our well wishes to Brian Fellows, who's in hospital, Pete.
Not well, Brian?
No, he's got a bit of an issue with his foot, so he's laid up in the Ballarat Hospital, and... nothing to do with coronavirus, but I'm sure the nurses will be glad when he goes home.
Sure, he wouldn't be pestering them much, would he, though? He'd be wanting the radio, the form guide, a can, And where'd Yogi race it?
He probably doesn't even know he's been retired. Probably have to give him a call. No, he's been laid up in hospital for a couple of weeks. So.
I've seen the old bear out in the paddy. He looks pretty happy with himself. He's been with three girls.
He loves it. He's a lovely animal.
Absolutely.
Just a lovely animal.
He's just a ripper. And as Tom said, those horses that are good, not in an arrogant way, but they've just got a presence.
Yeah, he's just a lovely horse. Now, the girls were disappointed when we moved him from the paddock behind the house, where they could see him from the office.
Well, he's got three young fillies in with him. He's real happy.
He's okay over there. Yeah. He's got his big rug on.
Yeah, no, he looked well. He wasn't too happy when we took it off just to get some photos.
Oh, that's good.
He got the rug back on.
Maybe we can chuck a photo up here.
Yeah, we'll put Yogi up. Obviously.
And well done on your farewell presentation. I had a lot of feedback from that. The guy that found him for us down in New Zealand, Mike Rennie.
I seen him.
He was very pleased.
I actually was in a hurry.
Brought a tear to his eye, he said.
Yeah. Well, when I looked at it, because I put it up on mine accidentally first, and then I put it up on ATB. Go back and have a look at all his wins bar Port Adelaide, which he hit the front 400 out. Every win, he only hit the front in the last 50 or 60 metres. In terms of, if you measured all his wins up and how far those races were, he was probably only in front for about 400 metres.
Yeah, that's right. We used to say when he jumped out, we'd go and get a coffee and come back and watch the last 100.
Yeah.
There's no point watching the race.
Like Matt Hill's calls were brilliant.
Yeah.
Rick's first call with Benalla was great. He set the scene for that career. And even the Adelaide caller, there's no boo-boos today. Yeah. He had a story, but everyone jumped on board.
Yeah.
As much as he was frustrating for the punters at times and the owners.
Everything had to go right. Yeah. He had a lot of ability and he was a wonderful horse.
Well, if you got 1 in 10 of him.
Oh, mate, he was a beauty. Yeah. We've got to find another one. But he'll have a great retirement. So he'll stay here probably for 3 or 4 months until he's let down properly and we make sure he's 100% sound. I know there's one owner there that's very keen to get him up there. To his farm where they've got a number of horses and daughter rides and they've got a dressage trainer there.
Beautiful.
So, we'll deal with that later on. But at the moment, I just want to make sure that he's sound, he's happy, and he just gets to let down properly before we do anything.
He's got grass up over his hocks. He'd be happy. He's very girls happy. Around him as well. He'd really
no
happy.
One sitting on his back feet.
No, and a rug on.
Beautiful. Well, that's a wrap for ATB TV this week. Until next week, I'm Darren Dance with Peter Morgandy. Stay well, stay safe, and keep punting.
In the meantime, he's entertaining three ladies here in this paddock, being the lad he is, and hopefully he can instill a bit of knowledge and ability into those three girls. But look, you can see he's a lovely horse, and as you said, Tom, he conducts himself with the purpose of a good horse.
He does. You can see why he's a good horse.
You really can. Right, guys, there's a little bit of vision of Yogi, and we'll be in touch once we... know more about his plans for his afterlife as a racehorse.